see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Welcome to this week's show. This week all about Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs and the witch who talked to furniture, basically. And she lived in this castle by herself, and to keep herself company she would talk to furniture. Not all the furniture talked to her, of course, but some of it did. For example, a mirror on the wall, and there was a small chair in the side of the room, and a sofa. And sometimes she'd say to the chair, do I look gorgeous? And the chair would say, nope. So she would pick up the chair and she'd start smashing it on the table, you see. And the chair would say, see, you can't smash me. I'm glued together with extra strong glue. And she'd say, right. And then she'd throw the chair and he'd say, see, I'm still not breaking. And then the mirror would intervene and go, cut it out, you two. So all you know is drama and violence. And she'd say, right, you're the one I want to talk to. Mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of us all, you know? And they say, well, actually, I'm feeling nervous. I don't want to answer the question now, because I've seen what you did to the chair. So look, that doesn't matter because it's not in the story, all right? It's just not even written down, is it? Just answer the question. Yes, okay. The woodcutter. She goes, you can't say the woodcutter. I said, well, I just did. And she said, look, I didn't say who's the queerest, right? We all know that he's the queerest. But the mirror said, well, no one else knows that. She said, well, then how do you know? He said, because I've got a good friend who's a mirror in his cottage. And he tells me all about how he gets dressed up in his funny little outfit. Braces, hat, funny little feathers sticking out, knickerbockers, struts around the room. And yeah, she said, look, I don't want to know any more about it, right? He said, right, just answer the question. Who's the fairest of us all? And he said, okay, in actual fact, it's Snow White. She'd get all enraged. She said, no, back off, back off. Don't touch me. And she said, why not? She said, because you can't. It's not in the story. She said, okay. I want Snow White's head cut off. He said, well, I'll do it, but I don't even own an axe. She said, well, look, I don't mean you, right? I'm going to get the woodcutter to cut Snow White's head off. He said, okay, fine. I don't want anything to do with it. She said, so she approached the woodcutter and said, look, I want you to cut Snow White's head off. He said, what am I going to do with Snow White's head? What are you going to do with it? And she said, well, it's not like that. I just want her dead, all right? You're a woodcutter, so I... Cut her head off. That'd be nice. I'm not into that. So she said, if you don't cut her head off, I'm going to tell everyone in the community about you dressing up in the little knickerbockers and the hat with the feather and everything you get up to. And believe me, I know. He said, all right, I'll do it. He said, by the way, how do you know about that? She said, you've got a mirror in your room, haven't you? He said, I do. Right, I know. It's been talking. He's been talking to other people. I thought he only talked to me. Right. His word doesn't mean anything. Right. So, the woodcutter, right, went off through the woods and he found Snow White with the dwarves. And he said, Snow White, I've come. Snow White intervened and said, look, I know where you've come from. He said, no, in actual fact, I'm not so interested in you, Snow White, for various reasons. She said, no, I know what you've come for. You've come to cut my head off. She said, look, a better idea is this, that we find a pig, right? And take the pig's heart out and you take that back to the queen, or the witch. And he said, look, with all due respect, you're quite, actually are quite pretty, and you don't look anything like a pig's heart. I don't think she'll be that confused. She said, well, her eyesight is going, you know, it's fading. And I think it might work. So they found a pig, right? Cut its head off. Cut its heart out. Took it back. And they took it into the woodcutter took it into the queen. To the witch. And the chair said, ah, it's Snow White's head. And the mirror said, ah, yes, it's, what have you got with Snow White's head for? And the witch, whose eyesight was terrible, you see, it's failing terribly, said, so this is Snow White's head, is it? And the sofa butted and said, actually, it's a pig's heart. And she said, what, a pig's heart? You mean to say Snow White had a pig's heart for a head? And the mirror said, look, you sofa, you should keep your mouth shut. Yes, she's very strange, that young lady, and she's kind of like, she's grown up with a pig's heart for a head. The witch said, how peculiar. No wonder she was so ugly. I thought she was. And the moral of the story, of course, is that if you're really very pretty, you have to understand that not everyone shares your opinion. And some people, like the witch, may believe, in actual fact, you're really very ugly. So there you go, that's this week's show. Thanks for watching. Please check out this channel, right? Thanks a lot. Please rate my video, even better subscribe, and I'll see you next week.